Hey guys, welcome back to Status Details YouTube channel, and today we are doing a guided maintenance wash on this ZL1 Corvette. So basically what we're doing is this car is going into storage, so this is like his end of the year maintenance wash. Now you could totally be doing this wash 2-3 times a year in the middle of summer or whatever, but this is what we're doing before this goes into winter storage. The deal is I'm going to show you every product and every process that I use. This might not be like by the number 10 steps, or technically it's more, technically it's less if you really want to break it down. The point is I'm going to guide you through this process so you know exactly what products to use and what process to use. It's two steps. So you guys know how to do this at home. So all this stuff is sold on statusdetailstore.com. You don't have to use my products. You could do everything I'm about to do with Adam's polishes or chemical guys or whatever stuff you want to use. I wouldn't use that stuff. But keep in mind, this video is not sponsored by Geon. It's not sponsored by G-Technic. And I sell all these products because I believe in them. I have no affiliation to those websites. This is not a sponsored video. It's just what I believe in. Let's jump into it.
Let's start with wheels first, like we always do. We're gonna use Brake Buster on the tires and the rims. We're gonna use Wheel Woolies on the rims, and we're gonna use a scrub brush on the tires. I'll show you specifically on the back. They were mounted recently and that like mounting grease is on there. And I don't use the tire brush often, but this is a perfect time to use it. Let's jump into this and I can show you.
First up, we're gonna spray Brake Buster on the tire, the rim, the caliper, the whole thing. You can't over spray Brake Buster, so use as much as you want. Don't go super crazy, otherwise you're just wasting product, but spray more than less. Then we're gonna use the IK foamer, and the IK foamer in this case has GSF soap in it. The main purpose of us using this is we have a gloss black rim and we don't wanna scratch that, so extra lubrication with a little extra foam is always helpful. When you're cleaning like a machined aluminum wheel or something like that, it's almost impossible to scratch it. But a gloss clear coat black rim is going to be easier to scratch, so it's always great to add as much lubrication as possible. You can use a foam cannon for this, or an IK foamer is always great too. Then you can see our little scrub brush coming out. The front tires weren't that bad, but I wanted to use this on this detail, and we're gonna see the more of this in the on the back wheels in a second. But this is a great brush to clean rubber. You'll see in a lot of my other videos, I don't use this when the tires is not very dirty. But in this case, the tires are pretty dirty, especially the rear tires have lots of like mounting grease, which we're gonna have to remove. But in general, it's a great tool to have. It will clean your tires better than just using the wheel woolly and rubbing the tire with the wheel woolly. The tire scrub brush is designed to really get in there and really clean your tires nicely. Always clean your fenders as well. The fenders are always important to rinse and clean really good. And then after all that, you can see the rim is clean now, so we're spraying Geon Wet Coat on the rim. You can also use CarPro Hydro, but in general, this is a spray-on, rinse-off, hydrophobic ceramic sealant. So you can see how, you know, hydrophobic that rim is now. I mean, it is really, really hydrophobic. It's beating water really nicely, and that was all real time. So you saw I sprayed that on, I rinsed it off, and it, like, basically ceramic-coated that wheel. Wet coat is not a ceramic coating. It is a ceramic sealant, which means it's not going to last, you know, 2 years or a year. It will last a couple months. It might even last 6 or 7 or 8 months if the car's not driven much like this car. And it actually has relatively decent heat tolerance. So even though this is a rim that will get hot, I've noticed putting wet coat on the rims of my car in the wintertime, you know, it'll last 3, 4, 5 months, even through the salt and snow and stuff like that. So Wet Coat is a fantastic product, super easy to take care of your wheels. And again, you can see the water beading is really, really crazy. Really impressive product. All right, let's tackle this back wheel now. Now the back wheel is the one that you can see the brown is all over it. And that's kind of just from a new tire, like they call it, like browning out. Like it's kind of like a tire bloom thing where like it has dirt that comes out of it and oil that comes out of it when it's new. But you can also see towards the, you know, between the rim and the tire, there's buildup of that like mounting grease. So I'm really, really getting in there with the scrub brush here. I am really kind of grinding out that dirt from the rubber. Be careful here when you're using this brush. You don't want to overlap too much onto the rim because you could potentially scratch the rim. If you touch it once or twice, it's not the end of the world, but definitely be mindful of that. You're using a relatively stiff brush on the tires, and it's intended for tires and it's not intended for the rim. But this is the absolute best way to remove really bad dirt, especially that like baked and caked on mounting grease, because that can be really hard to remove. But as you will see in a second, it is very, very easy to remove when you have the right tools. And just like that, you can see during the rinse, we basically get all that dirt off. The tire looks basically brand new now, and all of that browning stuff is gone, and more importantly, all of that weird like grease stuff that was caked in there is all gone as well. So now the tire is good as new, and once it's all dried off, you can put your tire wet on of choice, but we'll cover that later in the video. Once again, we added wet coat, all the wheels got wet coat, and again, it was unbelievable, crazy hydrophobic properties that you get from wet coat for such something so easy and fast to apply. It's also not very much money, so it's great value. And on top of all of that, especially on a car like this with complicated rims, now you can blow dry your rims at the end of the detail, and it's much, much easier than trying to towel dry them, which is virtually impossible on most wheels.
Next up, we're going to do a pre-foam, which means we're going to use Q2 foam, which is like a heavy lifting foam. We're going to spray this on with a foam cannon. We're going to let it dwell for about a minute. Then we're going to rinse it off. Then we're going to grab Geon Bathe, refill this, foam it again. Then we're going to wash it with a wash pad. Q2 foam, we've got about maybe 2.5 ounces in here. Hopefully you can see this is only about halfway full. I wouldn't fill it any more than that, or you're just over-diluting and wasting your formulation, basically.
As the last slide said, unfortunately our video was corrupted there, so we did do a full wash, and after that wash, especially with Q2 foam, which is kind of that heavy lifting soap that really does a good job of declogging and cleaning up ceramic-coated surfaces, this ceramic-coated car now beads water like it was just ceramic-coated yesterday. So it is a really good process to do a proper wash when you're doing an annual or a storage maintenance, so next year your coating is in good health and ready to go for the year. And as you can see, this car is beading water really, really nicely. And because it's beading water so nicely, we will be able to blow dry the car like we would normally blow dry any car, but especially when it's this hydrophobic, it is really, really easy. And because of that, obviously the main benefits are we don't have to worry about scratching the car when we're drying because we're doing it completely touchless. So in this video, I am using a Works blower, which is about a $45, maybe a $50 electric leaf blower. I have a very expensive big boy blower, and I also have a very expensive big Master Blaster blower, which are like professional detailing tools. But as you can see in this video, you only need like a $45 electric leaf blower that you can buy on Amazon, and that's why I used that in this video. I wanted you guys to see something that's attainable. Some of you people might even own this, and if not, I mean, most people can afford a $40 blower. So whenever you finish blow drying a car, there's always going to be water on the car. So that's okay, we blow dry so we can get 99% of the water off. We still have a little bit of water left over at the end. So in this case, I'm using Geon Quick Detailer. You could use ceramic detailer or cure if you want to put like a layer of wax back on the car. I'm going to top this with something stronger so I don't need to put something stronger on, I don't need to put something weaker on the car, then put something stronger on top of it. I want to just put the strongest thing on the bottom layer. So I'm going to use this, which has very little like additives in it. This is basically just like a quick detail with no ceramic in it to dry, to help lubrication and stuff like that. And then I'm using our drying towel. This is one of the newer towels. It's two-sided in the sword just to dry it. So we're going to get all the water off. Then we're going to go inside and we're going to apply that thing I mentioned that's stronger than cure and ceramic detailer. Notice how I'm folding the towel smaller so I don't drag it on the floor, on the ground here. Okay, so we're going to put ceramic detailer in the door jams. You could also use cure in the door jams. I'm using ceramic detailer because it's less likely to streak when there's so much water. But I'm, you know, not going to do any fancy high-end wax on this stuff. So this is fine just to spray some ceramic detailer on as a drying aid to keep the doors from, you know, getting scratched or anything. And then we're using our nice towels here, and we're just going to wipe these down. Don't think too hard about this. Just wipe it one time, flip it to a dry side, go back over it, and you instantly feel that slickness from ceramic detailer. It's a really, really nice product. And like I said, this doesn't like to streak. Like cure will streak more if we put, if we start diluting it into like a door jam with water in it. I'd rather put cure on totally dry than, you know, this is more of a drying aid to me. Always remember, there's multiple parts to a door jam, so do your whole door jam if this is super dirty, don't use your nice drying towel. Use like a throwaway, like Casco towel. And then in the future, when it's cleaner, you can use your nicer towels. You just don't want to trash a towel doing a door jam. It's kind of a silly way to dirty a towel up, in my opinion.
This really is an important step. Don't, you know, skimp on this one, because if you're about to store your car, especially for 5 months or something, you don't want water sitting in certain spots, because it will water spot and it will be very difficult to remove it in the future, especially if you're on some kind of well water, which lots of our customers actually are. So really take your time, try and get your towel into every, you know, nook and cranny on the car to make sure you're getting all that water cleaned and dried off, and just really take your time with it. Trunk jams, the backside of your trunk, the jams inside your hood, like the one I'm showing right now, and then just under the hood in general, anything you can kind of get your moist towel on, kind of, you know, get some of the dirt out and clean up is really a great start to putting the car away.
Next up is interior cleaning, and this could easily be like 4 or 5 step process. We're just going to call it, for the most part, a 1-step process, and we're going to start with Alcantara cleaning, and then the upper part of the door is leather, so we're going to talk Alcantara and leather cleaning. Similar process, we're going to use Gion leather cleaner. We're going to use Gion leather cleaner on both of these surfaces, but we're going to do it a little different on the Alcantara part of the door, and then we're going to use interior detailer on the inside of the car as well. This is more for sanitizing. We're going to talk about both of these in a second. And then our this is mine that's weathered, but this is a older but still very, very good, these last basically forever, by the way, Gion leather leather brush. Really awesome for Alcantara and obviously for leather. Let's jump into it. All right, guys, so we can see this is a little bit matted down where you like would grab this to open the door. You rest your elbow here a lot, and then we've got dust and stuff. So for starters, I'm gonna try and get some of this dust out by just brushing it. The back part of this is easier to get into some things. We really just wanna get the fibers kind of moved in the right direction again. We want them fluffed up. So when you can get lines like this, that's the right idea. All right, now that we've got basically all the dust out, we're gonna take Gion leather cleaner and we're gonna spray this into the brush. Nothing crazy. And now I'm gonna work this into the fabric. You can already see how it's coming back to life a little bit. All right, that looks pretty good. Feels so much better now. You can really feel it. So we're gonna do that to basically the whole part of the door, this bottom part. This is not wet, by the way. Like, we don't want this to be wet. That's why we're spraying it real light into the brush. And then I'm gonna do the front part here. I'm not sure if you can see this, but that's the part he actually grabbed with his hand. I'm gonna do a little extra cleaner on this part, because we're cutting through a little more dirt, basically, that's in the Alcantara. All
All right, we're gonna take a towel here. All right, and that looks really good. We just gotta do this part. We're going to do the same process basically on the leather part, but I'm going to get this a little more saturated, and I'm actually going to, like, you're actually going to see that liquid going on. Very gentle. I'm really putting very little pressure, letting the bristles do the work for me. If this was more dirty, maybe we put a little more effort into it, but it's not that bad, so it just doesn't need much effort or friction. Leather can be very fragile, so you gotta be careful. I'm spraying very small amounts on. You don't need a lot of leather cleaner. It's gonna last a long time for you. And that should do it. We're just gonna take our towel now and wipe this all off. Flip it over. So on the bottom part of the door here, it's not real bad, so I'm just gonna spray this into my towel directly, and I'm just gonna do a little wipe. All right, now I'm gonna fold this one inside out. You could use a new towel for this, but you don't have to. And I am going to use Interior Detailer here. So this product, Interior Detailer, is, so Interior Detailer is basically designed as a disinfectant. There's a little bit of alcohol in here basically, so when we spray this onto things, it will kill germs. The agitation process of using leather cleaner, which is kind of a mild detergent with a brush, which is agitation and friction, does kill things, but they can't actually claim that this does kill things for legal purposes, whereas this has gone through testing to show that it will kill germs and microorganisms and things like that. So safely and legally, you can say this does actually do that. I use this on my own personal cars and in my baby car and stuff to keep my little girl clean and, you know, healthy inside of her car. Not clean, but it keeps her safe from germs and things like that. And also it's great for dusting, and also it's a really nice thing to use because sometimes Geon leather can leave a little bit of residue on something, and this will clean all that away. It's really nice for that. So I'm just going to take this, I'm going to spray this in, and I'm going to use this on the whole door. So you'll see that little bit of residue of this going on, but because there's alcohol in it, it's going to evaporate and it's going to leave a really nice finish. It has a very nice smell. I'm going to do this on the Alcantara, because it's gonna, you know, it's like cloth, and Alcantara can definitely hold germs. So I'm gonna spray that. I'm gonna spray that on here, and then I'm gonna use this on the Alcantara, the leather, the plastics, the whole door. This is just my last step for a clean interior. And then I always brush my Alcantara one way, because I think it looks nice. That's how it was when it was brand new, and I want my interior to look brand new. And there you go. While we are standing here, I'm going to take my Geon Prep And I'm going to spray this into a different towel. This is a different towel. I only use prep with this towel. And I'm going to clean my interior, my glass. Prep is alcohol-based as well. It's safe on tint. I've used it on so many cars with tint, including my own cars, for so long. It's totally fine. Because it's got the alcohol in it, just like basically every glass cleaner ever, it's going to evaporate and it won't streak. So you're going to have really crystal clear glass. This is one of the reasons we don't stock glass cleaner in the store. All you need is prep. It has multiple uses. I'd rather have a product with multiple uses than just a glass cleaner that I can only use on glass. And then while you're at it, do the outside, and then we'll apply a wax to the outside of this glass later. But this is basically the prep, which is literally its intended purpose, is to prep for wax and ceramic, and it's something to remove polishing residue or residues in general. So for cleaning certain things on a steering wheel, like in between some of these buttons and the centers of a steering wheel, I'll often use my Detail Factory brush. Hopefully you guys can see this. And I'm going to spray this directly into my Detail Factory brush bristles. And now I'm just going to kind of go in here. It gets really into the logos and stuff of steering wheels. And then you can go a little wider with it. And I'm just going to real lightly get into these buttons. Nothing too crazy. And then we're just going to wipe that back off. I'm kind of tucking the edge of the towel in here. I'm doing this on purpose because, you know, dust can get trapped in there, and I don't like seeing that when I turn my steering wheel. I don't want to see any of that dust in there. I want a steering wheel to be perfectly clean. So you can kind of tuck that in there and get that nice and clean. Extra points if you can do this without honking the horn, because we've all been there, right? I'm just putting the extra residue that I had on here and here and into the brush, kind of transferring it. And now I'm going to do the steering wheel real fast. This side. And once again, I'm going to turn this guy inside out. I'm going to take my ceramic detailer. I don't know if the lighting was good outside. Maybe it's better inside. Ceramic detailer. This is to sanitize again. And I'm just going to spray this here. I'm going to do the whole steering wheel, the buttons, everything. Definitely the carbon fiber. This stuff works on everything. And I'll show you in a second. It's very, very good on screens. So it's great at getting fingerprints and stuff off screen because it's got that small amount of alcohol in it. it does a really nice job of cutting through like grease, because we have, you know, like oil and stuff on our fingers and hands. That's normal. So here's one of my dog's husky hairs. If you've ever gotten a status detail, you maybe have seen a Maya or Moxie husky hair in your car. I have two Siberian huskies. They like to follow me even when they're not with me. All right, and that looks like a brand spanking new steering wheel. So in here we've got a pretty good amount of dust on the plastic parts here. We have Alcantara again, and then we have screens, and we have gloss carbon fiber. So just to drive this home, there's not a lot of dirt in a shift boot. There's a little bit of dirt on the leather, you know, the Alcantara of the shifter. Obviously you're touching that, so we'll clean that. But the carbon fiber, the screen, these buttons, the plastic, none of this needs leather cleaner because it's not going to be dirty enough. But all of these surfaces, and especially including the nav screen, all of them are going to love ceramic detailer, because this product is kind of designed for those things. It's just a bonus that this product also kills germs and keeps your interior like more sanitary. The fact that it does that is just a wonderful bonus. So we're going to use this on all of these things. I sprayed the towel, and now I'm just putting the towel on everything to try and get some contact time, get that alcohol on there. And the other little witchcraft they put in this product to make sure that it's cleaning. And we're dusting and cleaning kind of all in one step. Make sure to like put your finger into the towel and go into the little things like the shift, the handbrake is a hydraulic one, so you got to get your finger in there and kind of pluck all the dirt out. You can put your hand into the shift boot here and kind of clean the shift boot out. As long as the dirt is out and the dust is out of the shift boot, we can vacuum it up during the vacuum stage. And just like that, it works really, really well. And we're going to grab our leather brush and do the shift boot. Not the shift boot. This is the shift boot's down there. This is just the gear selector, gear shifter. And then remember, the last step is always go back over it with the disinfectant. This stuff smells really good, but it really doesn't linger so much, so you're not going to smell it unless you're applying it after it's applied and gone, like, you know, a couple hours later, you don't smell it. All right, and that makes for a very nice looking center console. All right, I'm not going to bore you with the rest of this process. I'm going to repeat everything I just showed you on the rest of the interior. The centers of the seats are Alcantara, with the bolsters being leather. So everything you saw, I'm going to repeat on those surfaces. The dash is Alcantara, so I'm going to do that as well on the Alcantara cleaning again. And then I'm obviously going to vacuum the floors for the most part. I think you guys get vacuuming, so I'm gonna leave that out of the video for you. But this is how I would do an interior. This is how I do my own interior. And on my own car, especially my baby car, which is our Audi S6, I'm using interior detail, or the one that like disinfects. I'm using that about once or twice a month, I'd say, just to make sure the car is always clean. We don't go too many places, just to the doctor and the grocery store for the most part. But I really love that product and use it all the time. Just as a peace of mind thing to make the inside of the car clean. It's flu season, but outside of that, there's still COVID stuff going on, and who knows when that's going to be over. So it makes me sleep good at night when I'm done cleaning my car and I go, hey, that car is disinfected. It's good to go for tomorrow. So if you're like that, you'll really, really like interior detailer on your car. All right, I lied. There was one more thing I wanted to talk about. So this is an attachment that I have for my rigid vacuum. It's part of like their car detailing kits that you can get from Home Depot. It comes with two of these, and this basically has some bristles on it. And this is really handy for cleaning Alcantara seats. If you have like Alcantara all over like this car does, you can kind of scrub a little bit, and this can dislodge little things and little pebbles of dirt and things like that. And then you can go over it with the leather brush. So if something is really dirty, or it's been a while, or it's not a car that's got very few miles on it, a product like this is really, really helpful. I don't sell this, just check it out on homedepot.com. I'm sure Amazon has it too. All right, all jokes aside, so we're going to put EXO on the car. Now at this step, you could put Q2 wax on the car. This is stronger and harder to apply, where Q2 wax is easier to apply and not as strong. Today I'm going to show you how to do this. We're going to use a Gion suede applicator and one of these little blocks. These are super inexpensive in the store. This is my preferred way to apply this product. And then we're going to use a Costco Kirkland, I think they're called, Kirkland microfiber towel. We are using this instead of our nice towels because once the ceramic goes into this towel, it will harden and it will ruin this towel. So I don't want to use a nice towel and then throw a nice towel in the garbage. I'd rather use one of these kind of, you know, throwaway towels to ruin and throw away. So I'll show you how to do it. Feel free to pause the video and read all this stuff if you like. That's the most important side to read if you were curious to read something. This is pretty old now because I've reused it a couple times, but this is the Gion block. And then you can see the suede, and then notice how I cut the edges with a razor, and I take a flathead screwdriver and I push the edges in. Otherwise you'd have to hold the block like this. Now it doesn't matter how I hold it because the block is kind of holding that applicator in there for me. Alrighty guys, so inside of the EXO box, you're gonna have a bottle of EXO in there. Put this down. So to be perfectly clear, EXO comes with its own applicator pad where you can like put your fingers in there like that and you can like wipe this on. I don't like this thing. It tends to absorb way too much product and just in general I don't like this. So I don't recommend you use this, but if you don't want to spend the extra like whatever it is, like $6 or $7 to buy the stuff that I recommend, you can just buy this box and this will come inside of it and you can do the whole thing without any extra materials. I don't recommend you use this though. And just to cover this real fast, so I'm gonna wear a mask because I do this every single day and like it's smelly, I get little headaches when I put coatings on. EXO doesn't have too much of a smell or like too overwhelming of a smell. Crystal serum does, so if you're using crystal serum, I kind of recommend you use some kind of face covering, even if it's like some kind of like small mask like you'd wear to the grocery store. In general, I'm recommending you wear some kind of mask. If you don't wear one, that's your decision. I don't think the jury is out on what this stuff does do us yet. So I wear a mask because I think it's the best thing for me. You can do whatever you think is best for you. All right, I'm gonna try and show you guys exactly how much I would put on here. So here we go. That was my first application because it was dry, so I put a little extra on.
All right, so I'm going to show you two different versions of this. Basically, the first version that I'm showing you here is that I'm going to put this on really, really thick. So I poured a lot on, in my opinion, of EXO onto the applicator, and now I'm putting this on. You want to work relatively small areas. I'm working a relatively large area here, but I'm also very comfortable using this product. But having said that, I'm still only basically doing about a half of this hood, or if you're not counting that center vent, I'm really only doing about a quarter of the hood. So work in whatever area and space you feel comfortable in, but don't do the hood, the bumper, and the fender at the same time. That would be too much. Only work about half the hood and then the other half, and then you could work like half a fender and then half a fender. Once this product is applied, you can wait anywhere from 10 to 30 seconds basically and then start removing it. Just kind of look at it, and if it seems to be almost evaporating from the panel, then you either put it on too thin or you're just putting it on just right and it's just time to remove it really quickly. So in general, wait about 10 seconds, 15 seconds, 30 seconds, any time in between is going to be enough to basically remove this. This is a pretty flexible product that's pretty hard to screw up as far as removal time. times, so you have a lot of wiggle room. Crystal serum is much more of a conversation about removal times. You can leave this on for a minute and still remove it, and you would be fine. That's why I'm telling you 30 seconds. So don't think that 30 seconds is like the very edge of it, and now you're getting in trouble. The biggest deal here is, and you'll see me doing this in the video right now, wipe past the area that you put the ceramic on. So I'm wiping the front hood right now, but I didn't put any ceramic on the front hood. I'm just making sure that any residue I wiped past, same thing, I'm doing it again on the fender now, anything that I possibly accidentally wiped past the hood and onto that fender, I need to make sure I pulled that residue off those surfaces. So wipe past the spot that you do to make sure you're getting all the surrounding residue. Now, again, in this view, I'm going to show you two things. So this is the application one, where it's the thicker application. So this is just a view where you can really see it. So look how thick that looks as it's going on, okay? And then in a second, I'm going to show you, I'm going to thin it out so you can see what it looks like if you put it on thinner. Both of these applications are acceptable. The first application will give you a longer durability because there's more product, and you can let the first application sit longer because it has more ability to dry and not totally dry out because it was a thicker application. Now, in the second shot here, you can see I'm taking this and I'm kind of knocking it down and thinning it out a little bit. So this is the original first application I just did. Only after about 20 seconds or so, I'm coming back and I'm actually thinning it out with the same applicator, but I'm not applying any more ceramic to my applicator. I'm just using the same applicator to thin out this first application. And basically, if if you're having problems putting too thick of an application on, you're having a hard time removing it, you might be putting it on just too thick in general, and you might need to do what I'm doing here, which is thin it out a little bit. And that can make the process of removing it a little easier. And now you can see that I come in with the towel to remove it, and you can see even on my first wipe here, I'm basically getting this on the first try. But when you're removing EXO, you're going to wipe one time. That's going to kind of level it and kind of remove most of it, like 50% of it. Then you're going to come back a second time with the towel flipped, and you're going to remove the rest of that 50% that you didn't get the first time, which is going to get you to 100%. Then you're going to flip one more time or just have a second towel. And you're going to make sure that if there was 1% of anything left on there that you're getting it, which I know adds up to 101%, and that's not the point. The point is you're going to wipe this three times. You're going to wipe it one time with a towel to make sure you're getting, you know, everything kind of leveled and minimized. Second wipe basically gets it perfect, and the third wipe is really a precautionary wipe to make sure we're not leaving anything behind. Your third wipe is the one that kind of helps prevent high spots.
In my opinion, the last step of every detail, it's not done, it's not perfect until you get the tires dialed in. So we always use Q2 tire now, hopefully that shows up, Q2 tire, and we're gonna probably spray something onto the rims just to make sure they're perfect. I'm probably gonna use ceramic detailer, and I'm gonna do Q2 tire, where's that darn logo? I'm gonna do Q2 tire first, then I'm gonna do ceramic detailer, because I might get a little bit of this on the rim, and I'm gonna clean that off. If I do ceramic detailer first, then this, I'll have to chase my tail, and I don't like doing things twice. This is like a rag towel. I'm basically gonna destroy this. You can use the applicator, tire applicator I have in the store, but you don't have to do that. I personally do this most of the time. So let me show you. Pretty straightforward. So I'm basically going to take a corner of this as a spray nozzle on here. And I'm just gonna spray this into the corner of my towel, okay? And then I'm basically just gonna wipe this on. The first application never goes good, so my first tire always goes worse than my second, third, fourth tire, and that is because that's because this is dry. So once this gets a little more saturated, it's gonna work better, and that's why the other tires go better. So I usually do five tires. I do the first tire one last time when I'm done, and I get around my entire car. I always go a little past the sidewall. That will just wear off as soon as you start driving, and then you're gonna get like a super perfect tire line where the tire wet ends and where the tire wet starts. This stuff smells so amazing. It's like a blueberry. I think it's blueberry, man. I don't know. It's super good smelling. It's hands down the best smelling product I think I use when I clean the car. It's just a joy to use this stuff, and it looks so good. So we're going to keep going. I'm probably going to time lapse this real quick just so I can get all this on. It's a little slower process to put this on than some other products, but in my opinion, it looks the best. So it's worth the little extra time you got to put into it. And then I usually, so I was double layered there. Now I'm going to do one layer basically. I'm going to put my finger in there like that, and I'm going to do this edge. You're kind of just following it and tracing it, and then that comes out perfect. I'm flipping this over, okay, and now I'm going to wipe it all off. And again, I'm going to put my finger in there like I did. Doesn't matter if you drop this on the floor, don't worry about it. And we're going to go back in. We're going to wipe out that little ring. This is rarely done on most cars, the ring. And that is why you pull a lot of dirt out. That's actually not that bad. Usually we get way more dirt than that when we do that little ring. Like there's leaves and stuff in here because I just dropped this. We're just cleaning tires, so don't worry about it. This is not something we're going to use on the tire on the rim. We're literally only using this on that rubber, and that's perfect.
Just like that, this video is over. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you took away some really good educational information on this, on how to do a maintenance detail at home. I've been getting lots of comments on some of our videos, especially the Senna maintenance video, which this kind of complements really well. That shows you the guide on how to do it. This really shows you the action, how to physically do it. In terms of maintenance details, and you guys are commenting like, you know, thanks so much for the educational videos. I hope you guys really are learning, stuff from our videos. That's the idea. That's the goal. Even if you're not using my products, if you're just taking my process and using your chemical guys or whatever you have, that's awesome. I want to be a part of, you know, helping you guys do maintenance at home. So if you have any questions for me, like always, comment below and I will get back to you right away. If you like this video, we have so many more videos like this coming. So make sure to subscribe to the channel if you're enjoying what you're watching, especially if you made it all the way to this end of the video. All right, guys, that's going to wrap it up. Make sure to like and subscribe and comment if you've got any questions. And I'm going to give you a little cinematic outro. See you in the next one. Bye.